Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on The Witcher 3. Sorry I missed a day. Family's going on vacation without me. I have to stay home because I have summer college classes and I can't miss multiple weeks of it, obviously. So I can't go on the vacation. So I'll be home and I'll be able to get a lot of recording done. So starting Saturday is when they leave, and then they don't get back for 2 weeks. So we'll have plenty of time to record. But in this episode, we are going to be doing a Witcher contract here. We're going to talk to Count Baletel. One day, girl happened upon an unusual contract notice. Someone was seeking the aid not of some unarmed Witcher, but specifically of the Witcher named Geralt of Rivia. The notice listed no other details, so Geralt, admittedly intrigued, resolved to see what was issued. Doesn't make any sense. But also in this episode, depending on time, I guess, obviously, but I want to go ahead and grab these notice boards. Are gold again, which tends to mean that there's new contracts. And I don't even think I went out here before, so this is like completely new. I don't know if I read a book or something, or if I talked to someone who helped me figure out that there were more contracts. But we're gonna go check those out, see if there's anything new for us. I'm gonna be honest, I don't have a great memory of what I've already picked up and what I haven't, so we'll probably just end up reading those anyway. But that's the plan for the episode. So let's go ahead and head out, and then probably in, where the heck is, okay, Roach. But, what was I gonna say? Totally spacing what I was gonna say. Let's go this way. At the start of the next episode, we'll probably have the, come on, Roach, let's cross the bridge. But hopefully we'll have house renovations done and we can go back and check those out and see. One of these days I'm gonna stock up the house and put weapons out and put, armor on the armor stands and all that stuff. Definitely have that done by the end of this playthrough, obviously, but, I don't have it done yet. Here's the
giant centipede spawning ground. Should destroy it.
What do we got here? We've got centipedes. Come here. No, what the hell? I can't even fight these things. Come here. You little shit. Come here! No, you little fucker, come here!
Show me what you got.
Alright, what are they doing now? Where are they coming up? Come here! Oh, you dick monkey! I just gotta guess. Oh god. Come on, dude. Come here. You son of a bitch, dude! I can't... Come here! No! What the hell?! Die! Come here, you little... Oh, you little dick monkey! Oh, my god. Come up out of the ground, you little... Just die! What?! Alright, I was gonna say...
Should destroy it.
I hate these giant centipedes. Go. Alright. Roach, come here. If we don't get to reading those notice boards in this episode, I will do it and I'll take care of it in the next episode. Big game hunt makes me think I'm hunting, I don't know what I was gonna say, I guess it makes me think I'm gonna hunt an animal opposed to, like, a monster. Like a real I don't know, like a-
Hey, over here.
Okay, I should just shut up because I'm not entirely sure what I'm trying to say.
Should be better than
what
fine.
Is this? Wine merchant.
Heard you calling. Wanted to talk?
I did. for we're neck deep in trouble. Of the spider kind.
Need a maid with a broom, not a witcher.
You fail to understand. These are huge, the size of pigs or dogs. Black and hairy, spewing webs.
Mm-hmm. Not talking about spiders, then. Talking about arachnomorphs.
Call them what you will. You must smash the rogues, will you? Those caves would be prime barrel storage were it not for the beasts.
First things first. Need to talk about my reward.
Not far now. We find ourselves a hair from agreeing.
Okay, how about 170?
Not far now. We find ourselves a hair from agreeing.
Alright, let's just do 160. Whatever.
I knew we would agree terms.
Arachnomorphs don't look much like bunnies, but they sure breed like them. Best nip the problem in the bud. I'll look into it.
Okay, so that's a new Witcher's contract. What level are we looking at that? I'm level 36, almost looking at level 37. Actually, don't even see it. I'm not... Oh, here, is it this one? Vinter's contract. Okay. Let's go ahead and talk to Count Belladel.
Lads, I find your concern touching, I do. Yet I've long awaited this day, so you must forgive me, but I shall go through with it as planned. Ah, it seems my guide has arrived.
Greetings.
Greetings to you, White Wolf. I presume you saw my notice? Foolish question. You're here, thus you must have seen it. Forgive me, I should introduce myself. Count Belladel, a great admirer of your deeds.
Thanks. Not something we witchers hear often.
But Count, sir, do you mean to go off with just this witcher? A right hardy fellow he is, no ponce, I'm sure. But your expedition's too risky on the whole. And not taking us with you's, pardon my saying it, right daft.
You exaggerate, Vilmar. I believe I can manage to survive half a day without someone there to wipe me arse in my stead. My guards lament, Witcher, but you must forgive them. Now, to get down to brass tacks. As you've no doubt gleaned from the notice, I've a rather extraordinary proposition for you. I'm a lover, Witcher, of nature. A devotee of the wild. And Toussaint is home to several species not encountered elsewhere. I'd like you to accompany me on an expedition whose aim is to... preserve them. Ahem. Ah, yes. Naturally, you'll protect me should the need arise. My ever-vigilant guards, see, will report any reckless behaviour to my wife if I get so much as a scratch. And then woe will be me.
Count Belladel? Famous poultry farmer, is that it?
Well, that was my grandpapa. Dear man. But my trade is the wine trade. I import the finest vintages to Kavir, my homeland. The very reason for my frequent visits to Beauclair, during which I like to, partake of nature, let us say.
Really need a witcher to, partake? Got guards of your own. Take them, save some coin.
I could, surely. But they too deserve a bit of rest, relaxation. Right, lads? Besides, I've plenty of coin. Coin that needs spending. Who dares stop me?
Ah, so this is about a rich man, bored stiff, seeking thrills.
There's also Clarissa, who...
Vilmar, please.
Who what?
My daughter. I always return from my travels with some souvenir or another. She looks forward to them tremendously. But we did not meet to chat about my family. We must discuss our venture, must we not?
Need some details before I can say anything. Where are we going? What am I supposed to do exactly?
In the roundest terms, we shall admire the local flora and fauna. And while we do, I might preserve a thing or two.
Preserve?
Of this device, see? A peristeisomach. It captures, likenesses.
A peristeisomach what?
It's like a movable megascope, capturing moments, transforming them into illusions, based upon which I then paint a painting.
So, you want me with you, looking at animals and flowers and...
Well, that's more or less what it amounts to, yes. Except you will first have to track down the creatures I wish to capture. I know only the very approximate locations of their habitats. Well, and should any trouble arise, we'll have your sword at the ready, right? So, agreed?
Pretty unusual contract.
I couldn't agree more, yes. And I'm prepared to pay a commensurately high fee.
Don't mind if we actually talk about exactly how high that'll be first, do you?
Why ever would I? Please, simply tell me how much you wish to receive. Sublime! We've a deal!
Doesn't seem hard. Be glad to do something pleasant for a change.
Sublime. In that case, here's your map. Before coming here, I dispatched requests to several local hunters. They located the habitats of the species of interest to me and marked out their ranges on the map.
Good thinking. It'll save us some time. Won't need to track. Ready to go?
Yes, let's. The light seems perfect just now.
All right, so we've got a map here, obviously, that he gave us.
Seems I got the map, so I'll lead.
All right, so we need a panther's lair, centipede's lair.
Wouldn't rather be out here with those guards of yours?
You jest. It's deliverance to emerge from under their wings, believe me. They're overprotective, oppressively so. I wish to admire the wildlife, preserve it. Not watch them kill it in a fit of misguided fear for my life.
What if the wildlife attacks us?
Then we shall have no other recourse. I do not wish to be something supper. You? But as long as they remain calm, we've no need to provoke them. It's of the utmost importance to me, in fact.
Why is he walking so slow? What is he doing? I'm just gonna leave him. I don't know. Why is he walking so slow? Can he not keep up? What is he doing? Come on. What? Why are you so damn slow? Let's go. Look at this. Why is his AI so stupid? Can he not run? Is this a thing? Do I have to walk? Look at how slow this is. This is ridiculous. Why is he walking so slow? Come on, dude. Come on.
Map says there should be panthers around here, hunting, panting. Something like a bear.
All right, let me kill this bear. Come here, bear. Where are you going? Come here. Come here, you little pussy. Don't run away. So up here's the panther's lair.
Hear that? Panthers.
Frankly, I did not hear a thing. Clearly, your senses are far more acute than mine. I must rely on them.
Damn poachers. Snares. Looks like they were hoping for a bear. Panther got caught instead.
Where is it? There we go.
Look, brilliant. You freeing it. Brilliant. You freeing her. A superb image. Folk call witches heartless. This will put the lie to that. Oh my! I failed to warn you. Apologies. The peristeisomach has an added lantern. You must look away, or it'll blind you!
Peristysomax upset the animals. Better get out of here.
Cannot abide poaching. I'm content you share my love for animals.
Got pretty broad interests for a man of the city.
I suppose I dabble in my share of things. Wine, nature, painting. I imagine the life of a witcher must be rather more monotonous. With all due respect.
It is. Never boring, though.
I, for one, cannot fathom only ever consorting with the same creatures, day in and day out.
Got a wife?
Yes. What's that got to do with anything?
Nothing. Just asking.
I'm just curious as hell. This guy, I swear, why do I have to walk so slow with him? Alright, we're here. Whatever. Giant centipede.
Hear him.
It's those...
Centipedes. Giant. Underground tunnel burrowers. Make a distinct sound. We can use that to track them.
Wait, hold on. I lost it. There it is. Where's this taking me?
Sounds loud and clear here. Must be near the nest. We're here.
Well, this vantage point's no good. I shan't capture a good image from here.
All right, wait. We'll find you a better spot. It's safe, too.
Wait! We would have found a safe place for me first! Blast it! I see you're simply unreliable.
Ugly bastard.
All right, well, oh, God. I done fucked up. So am I supposed to kill these things or just like run around in a circle and avoid them, like? Oh shit!
Exactly what I want. We've disturbed them enough. An excellent day for capturing moment. You went to find a place where I would have a good view. Instead, you ran into their lair.
Sorry, got carried away.
Did we accomplish the mission?
Exhilarating. Positively exhilarating. Thank you. I've one more request. Local peacocks performing their mating ritual. I'd love to see that. Apparently, a flock dwells not far from here.
We can go. Just don't count on peeping at them while they mate. Season ended a month back.
Oh, that's terrible. I so wish to capture their splendorous tails in full bloom. Is there nothing you can do if they prove uneager to present? Perhaps challenge them somehow? Goad them?
What did you have in mind? Don't have a tail myself, and I'm not likely to sprout one anytime soon.
My thoughts were more along the lines of witcher magic. They say you can exert influence over lesser creatures.
Yeah, guess I can try. Can't promise you anything, though.
Splendid. Consider me contented. I cannot pinpoint the flock's location, but a hunter I know told me a few likely spots. I'll mark them for you.
All right. Let's go find some peacocks.
All right. Let's go find these peacocks.
I was wondering. Why peacocks?
My daughter is rather fond of them. They will be a treat for her.
So you want to take a picture of peacocks mating?
Real close. Eyes in the back of your head.
He wants to take a picture of peacocks mating and give it to his daughter. It's a little weird.
A feather from the rump, coated in suet. Cock shed it recently and the suet's got a distinct scent. Ought to be able to track the flock.
A witcher in action. What a treat to watch.
What the hell?
Shh. Hear that? They're calling to each other.
Fabulous. We're getting close.
They're right here. am I supposed to do?
Oh, that's lovely. Now, if they could just splay the tails.
See what I can do. Find a good spot.
Ready! Use your magic, Witcher! This'll be a masterpiece! Smile, please!
Giant centipedes! Damn it!
Where did they come from?
Must have followed us. Get back!
Come on! Where is it? Why won't I... It won't let me roll. There we go. Are you kidding me, giant centipede? Stay up for longer than... 2 seconds! Whoa. Oh, well, that was the wrong thing to do.
All over now.
Whew, that was tense. I believe I've had my fill of excitement for today. What a wonderful adventure!
Get everything you wanted?
Yes!
In that case, time to get back to your camp.
Okay, that was an interesting quest. Kind of fun. A little bit different than the normal Witcher contracts.
Returning your lord to you, safe and sound.
You've our gratitude, Master.
You see, lads, there was nothing to fear.
Thank you, Witcher, for looking after our deer count. Seems the jaunt did him wonders. Breathed some new life into him.
Wait here a moment, Geralt. I have to fetch my coin pouch. Pay my dues.
New life? He was feeling down?
Made no mention, did he? 10 years back, his last, Clarissa's her name, took a spill off her horse. Been bedridden ever since. Cannot walk of her own. She'd been the life of the house before the calamity. A merry sprite what filled every corner with joy. Count would oft take her out on trips. She loved animals too. Excursions he makes now, or rather, paintings he brings home. They's her only window on the wider world.
Sorry to make you wait. Some of your shenanigans proved a little unnerving. Yet I still consider the day a success. Seems even witchers have a sense of humor. Do something deranged at times. Good to know.
Yeah, I'm a wild and crazy guy.
Your reward. Use it well.
Thanks.
I've one other matter I wish to broach. In a few days' time, I shall exhibit my work for some friends, my coterie, so to speak. Would you come by?
Why not, if I'm in the area?
Splendid. In that case, I shall see you at my lodgings. I'm staying with a friend while in Tucson, near a village named Francolar.
I'll be by. See you.
Drink! Give me a drink!
Wait until noon tomorrow and go to the picnic. Alright, we'll do that in this episode, I guess. Wasn't there a fast travel point? No, there wasn't. Alright, Roach. There's a cave here. Hold up. What's in here? Hold up, there's actually a thing. Holy level 43! Oh, this is the dude that wanted me to get rid of those spiders. How much? Oh, shit, they're just coming from all over. Okay, nope, not now. I can't do enough damage to him. Okay, so now... I need to head to this picnic. I wanna let me, there we go. Wasn't letting me zoom out. Alright, so we're here. Let's go grab this notice board real quick. I won't do that in this episode. We'll go to this picnic in this I'll just run. We're close enough. And then maybe we'll read the notice boards in the next episode. I think that would work out pretty well.
You smell that? Those are the vapors of Tucson.
Where is the fast travel point? Here we go. Let's go to this picnic. Alright. I gotta wait till noon, so we'll get over here and then I'll go ahead and wait. Okay, let's go ahead and get this the marker I placed off the map. There we go. And let's wait till noon. Okay, so the additional armor stands are available at Corvo Blanco. Additional weapon racks are available at Corvo Blanco. So we'll head back there at the end of this episode and check that out. But let's go enjoy this nice picnic. Oh, can I buy some paintings?
It's picturesque meadows and both male and female Beauclair centipedes are formidable predators. The bees prefer to hunt in packs. Yet the author of this extraordinary work was able to capture a lone specimen preparing to attack. Cast your eye on the hunter, who, though fully aware of the danger, wears a look of cold determination on his face as he awaits the optimal moment to strike.
Ah, Geralt, you're here. Wonderful. Come, please.
I'm delighted to see you.
I have a small gift for you, and I shan't let you refuse.
You are free to sell it, of course, though I would be honored were you to hang it in your home.
Thanks.
I will hang that in my home.
Talked to your guards back at the camp. Told me about Clarissa. Sorry to hear about her accident.
Thank you. Kind words that mean a great deal to me.
How's Clarissa these days? Probably can't wait for you to get back.
To get a gift, you mean? I've dispatched two already. She'll not need to wait for my return. En route home, I mean to pass through Dol Blathana. They say one can see Sylvan's there.
Yeah, actually happened to know one. Name's Torque. He can be mean, but for the right fee, he'll do anything you ask.
Splendid. I thank you for the hint.
Tell him I send my regards. Good crowd. You got a lot of friends. All of them seem to be fawning over your paintings, too.
Oh, when you have as much coin as I do, friends buzz around like flies on fresh meat. And they praise you to high heavens for each trip, burp, and sneeze. Not all are lying sycophants, that's not what I mean. Just most. Unfortunately.
Why bother? Why even invite them around?
I'm a man of enterprise, and must put my trade before any personal hatreds or sympathies. Besides? At times, I'll exhibit a completely failed painting, just to listen to them twist their tongues into knots, trying to find just the right superlatives to lather on smeared rubbish. Naturally, the more intent someone is to get into my good graces, the louder they praise my masterpiece. It's devilish fun, I tell you.
Nice meeting you. So long now.
Quest completed. Big game, Hunter. I kind of wish I could buy these paintings, too. A Witcher taming peacocks. It's a really cool picture.
It's wonderful to meet the subject of the Baron's new cycle. Such an opportunity.
The White Enjoy Wolf the taming Beauclair centipedes.
No ointment could help. Excuse you.
I imagine you've been all over the world.
We got here. Geralt and a panther. I kind of wish I could have gotten the one with the panther. I think that one's pretty cool.
Oh,
but this is really cool to get these paintings. I'm not entirely sure. Maybe I'll do a little research at work today, figure out exactly where I can get a lot of paintings from. There should be a where's the fast travel point? We need to go back to the house anyway. Where is the... There it is. I see it. Alright, where is my house? Here it is. Corvo Blanco. I can't wait to... There's like a part of me that's like, I can't wait to finish this house and this area and all that different stuff. And then there's a part of me that's like, I don't want it to end. I want to keep making additions, keep doing cool stuff to the house. So I'll go ahead and hang this picture in my bedroom because I think... You don't get a great view of it, but... We will now when we hang it up, so I'm pretty stoked.
To do before it gets dark.
Alright. I'm not sure... There's the new armor stand there. Not entirely sure where else we've got new armor stands. Probably upstairs. We'll go check upstairs here in a second. Alright, let's hang the painting right over here. There it is. Can I not look at that more clear? I don't know, but that's a really cool painting, too. It's actually really cool. It's like something really to remember the quest by, because there's the peacocks, there's a centipede, there's a panther on the side. That's a really cool picture. I'm happy I was able to get that. What's up top here? Do we get a weapon stand up here, probably? Actually, no. This is just a really nice, quaint little bedroom upstairs. Alright, so let's go ahead and talk to our homie Majordomo. See what he's got for us to upgrade now.
Renovations coming along all right?
Wonderfully. The furnishings you last had me order have arrived.
Alright.
Starting to really like this place. Maybe we should keep going, refurbish some more. What do you think, BB?
With the utmost respect, sir. The vineyard has arrived at the pinnacle of perfection. Any further changes could prove a regrettable step down the slope towards the brash. I firmly advise against it.
Aw, are we really already done?
Thanks. Gotta get back to my business now. See you soon.
Aw, what? Is that really all the upgrades I can do to the house? Let me see here. Where's my house? No place like home. Okay, so let's go ahead and wait these 2 days. Wanna see, are we already done with the house? If we're already done making renovations to the house, I'm disappointed. It's kinda sad if this is it. Thought for sure it'd at least have like a few more upgrades. Oh, that's it.
Go up to any knight.
Wow, that's it. Well, that's disappointing. The stable looks nice. Everything looks nice. Alright, let's go talk to Majordomo. I think this is it. I am disappointed that that's all. There's not a whole lot left, but I'm still disappointed.
Renovations coming along all right.
I am delighted to inform you we have completed our labors. You can now devote yourself to enjoying the vineyard's delights to the fullest. You must forgive me my temerity, sir, but I thought with all the work on Corvo Bianco completed, and with the estate looking more beautiful than ever, it might be appropriate to commemorate the moment.
Sure, why not?
During the tidying that preceded the renovations, I came across a bottle of Sapramento, the 1250 vintage. I cannot say by what miracle it survived, but it is here. And we've course to open it today. And then he ran straight into the crowd, burning bouquet in hand. All thought it a part of the performance, so they only laughed, even when the decor began to catch fire. It was not until the flames engulfed Baron Mahefkin's beard that folk began to realize something was amiss and went to put out the fires.
Sounds like Monsieur Bolius and Madame Nina threw some first-rate balls here.
It was so. In this regard, Baron Drossel was decidedly more reserved.
So tell me, Barnabas Basil, what's the wine situation like here? Am I going to produce any this year?
This year is out, I fear, sir. Last autumn, a fungus destroyed all the vines. Baron Drossel had new ones planted, but it will be some time before they start bearing fruit. Assuming that is, the fungus does not reappear.
That'd be bad. This Sepramento got me dreaming. It's amazing.
Isn't it, though? Allow me to top you off, sir. There.
Thanks.
All right, well, that's all the editing we've got for the house. Quest completed, No Place Like Home. I guess that will do it for this episode, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. I'm disappointed that's the end of the house, but we can start really getting into furnishing it and making it look as awesome as I possibly can, which I will do my best to do. By the end of this playthrough, I'll try to make it look awesome in here with paintings, weapons, armors, and just different stuff. I wish there was a little bit more you could do up top here. Maybe hang more than just one painting over there. Maybe weapon stand, another weapon rack, something like that. Maybe some... There are a lot of places they could have added some extra stuff, even though this house is kind of small. But I'm happy that they at least added a house and I have, like, a home to go back to and hang out at. But that's going to do it, guys, for this episode. Drop a like if you did. Subscribe if you haven't. And I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace out.